Well, here we are again. Reason 11 plug-in VST3 Ableton with Logic. I'm gonna show you guys how to set that up. So if you want to use Logic or any, like, you know, you can't use it now because it's a VST3, but there is a way you can use this inside of Logic. Alright, I'm just gonna break it down real quick how I have. I'm just gonna set up a template for you guys. If you follow this here, yours should set up just like mine's. So this, you might have to pause the video to do what I'm doing, but I'll explain it as I go along. I already have like a basic old instrument right here inside of Ableton. So I'm just gonna I'm gonna go right here first of all. I'm gonna go to the plugins. You guys know how to get into your VST3 plugins. If you don't know how to get into your VST3 plugins, let me show you real quick. We'll put this all in one video. If you can't find the Reason rack and you're looking for it and it only see the AU audios, you know, the audio units and the VST, and you don't see the VST3, you need to go to preferences, and then you need to go down here to right here to the plugin folder. You go right here to the plugin, and when you come down right here, you're gonna see it's gonna say use VST3 plugin system folder. It's right here. As soon as you turn this here on, it's gonna activate over there, and then you just close this here out, and then you have your VST3s right here on the left side. Whatever other VST3 programs that you have, they're gonna all be in there. Along in there, you're gonna see your Reason Studio, and then you got your rack plug-in. Just drag your rack plug-in in there. What I'm gonna do is, now I drag one in there, I'm gonna delete that first instrument that I had in there, so I can have all Reason rack. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run 8 tracks of Reason. So I'm gonna load up 8 Reason racks. Now you have 7. You have eight Reason racks. Now, I have mine already set up, so this is what I'm going to suggest for you guys to do now. You need to save this right here with the 8 Reason racks. And inside of your Reason rack, you can start like I have 8 of them right there, right? So I can actually line these here up like this here. I just go to each one, and I line them up. I mean, it's your preference just so you know, like when you load up your template, that everything's gonna line up. So I usually just put like everything right here. I'm gonna line all of them up real quick. So now I have all these right here. They're all lined up in there. They might be jumping around a little bit. They're not totally lined up all great or whatever like that. But I'll load like one instrument in there. And I hit my key. I'm on track 8. You know what I'm saying? And I can switch it over. That's what I loaded it in there as though. I should have loaded it in 1. So, I mean, I do have audio. That's what I was checking for. So I'm going to go here. I'm going to delete this here. Now you got it right there. You want to set this here. You can set that to 1. Now you got these here lined up and you know that they're going to open. You can actually come to this little arrow on the right hand side over here. And this right here will close that up. And now you got your rack looking like this here. I mean, It looks decent. I mean, everything's there. I mean, other than I'm using the Bash Commander from Slate. I mean, but everything right here looks good. So what you want to do then is you want to come up here to Live, go into Preferences. Let me move this over so you guys can see this right here. And then you want to go down here to File Folder. You're going to click on the File Folder right here. And at the very top right there, it's going to say Save Current Set as Default. Click Save. Mine is already saved, so I'm not going to click it. But click Save right there. It's going to save. Now it's going to save your preferences. You can now close Live up. Go ahead and close Live. And you can go and open up Logic. Now, what you need to do in Logic is you need to go in there and you need to go and turn off your rewire. Because when you use Logic and Ableton together, Logic always wants to become the master, and take over everything, and you have to use Ableton as the slave. Now, when you try to use Logic as the as if you make Ableton the slave, then it won't let you load up the plugin. It has to be in Ableton for it to work. So you want to be able to load up Ableton first. So what you're gonna do right here in Logic, you're gonna come up here to your preferences. You can click on your audio. And then all the way down, you want to click, make sure that device is checked right here. Click down right here to the bottom. It's going to say rewire behavior. Just turn that off. Okay. Now, when you close out Logic, you're going to open up a fresh session of Ableton. Now, when you open up your Ableton, your template's gonna pop up. And then once your template pop up, then what you're gonna do is you're gonna open up Logic. So I'm opening up Logic. I have a session just with audio tracks in there. So if you want to use Logic, you can go ahead and you can write this track into Logic, and you also can you can still record your vocals into Logic and do your mix and mastering. You can still use Logic effects and everything, and you can still. Like, I mean, you see how I got this here, and I just be making stuff so it kind of like fits in there. You can actually set this here as a template as well. So when you do, after you open up Ableton and then you open up Logic, it'll automatically open up into this square, just like it, and it will look like this here every single time. Now the way this here works is, I don't have these here tracks right here routed all the way out 1 through 8, which you can. Now, the way another easier route you can do this is, me, I like to let Ableton record all the audio right here from the Reason Rack right into Ableton as the session. And then, I can still change over to my session right there in Ableton, and it's there. So everything that I'm gonna write out is gonna pop up in there anyway. or it's gonna pop up in if I decide to write it in a clip. Oh, that's my. That's my setting right there for my interface right there. So, all right, the way it is now is whatever you can put it like this here. Let me make sure that there's a track or something loaded up right here in the rack of the first one. Now, the way I would do it is I will put it in a clip, and I'll select that clip right there to record in there. I'll load an instrument up. Now, remind you, this might be something corny. This is just a demonstration to show you how to connect it. So once I do this, you'll be able to do whatever you want to do, and I'm pretty sure it's gonna come out a lot greater than this. But this is just how you set it up. So I'm just going to load an instrument in there. And you see on the MIDI that they're hitting on every single channel. So you know that there is MIDI coming in on every single channel of the Reason Rack. And of course in Ableton, you got to set the input. And then you're going to hear your instrument. Now, you can, everybody knows, if you're going to record in Ableton, you can record it as a clip, or you can record it into the actual session. The arranger of the session. So, what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to record it into a clip. So, we'll record it into a clip. Alright, that's just to show that, that there's something in there on that track. So I play it back. Alright, this is just to show you that there's something on that track right there. Press stop. Alright, now, you can do that on any track. You got all your tracks lined up right here, so, and you got it set as a template. There's going to always pop up the Reason Rack lined up already. Just got to load your instruments in there. Now you got that loaded in there. You actually can come into Logic, and when you hit play, and then you see that there is audio in there, right? You see that there's audio in there, right? So, keeps popping away when I'm doing that right there. And the only thing I'm trying to do is just minimize this here. Alright, so I'm going to get Logic back open real quick. So now you got right here in Logic, and you can record in there at any time. If I hit record down here, let me hit stop real quick. Now, another thing you can do is, if that keeps popping away on you guys, you can always here make this here smaller, like this here. What I do is I would delete something that I don't have. Like, I took the reverb out, because I can always change this delay right here to reverb or something like that if I want it. And then I just move this here over like this here, and then now I got both of my, I have both of my sessions going now at the same time. So now when I hit play, you'll see everything's now is on its own screen, and everything looks a lot better. Everything's functioning correctly. Everything still works perfect on that right there. As you set the loop right here on Logic, if I hit record down here, it's gonna record it in there. So now if I play that back and mute the track that was that was recorded in the session. Only if I play it back, only thing you're gonna hear is just what's in. That's in Logic. Now, another thing what you can do is you can still record that in there like that, and then you can move on to your next rack and on and keep recording. And as you're recording, you can just activate these tracks right here and record whatever you have in your session right here, and then it's already set for a loop, and you know, you can arrange it and everything, and you're good to go. I mean, this is a quick, real quick workflow for you guys. If you guys trying to really get it to work inside of Logic, I mean, this is how you're gonna do it. Only thing you're doing is you're gonna use the rewire of Ableton, and then you'll be able to use the rack inside of Ableton and then record it inside of Logic. Okay? If you guys have any questions, and if there's anything else that I can help you guys out with setting this here up, just leave some feedback or something, and I'd be glad to just, I'm always in and out on YouTube, so just, you know, I always come back and I check, and I'll respond, and if you guys need any help, just let me know, and I'm right there, and I can help you guys set that up, because I know how it is to have to wait to the end of the year to want to use this plug-in with Logic, you know what I'm saying? But in the meantime, in between time of waiting for the AU or VST to come in, this is another way you can route that in there, you know what I'm saying? And it's going to work. So, I mean, check out this video, I mean, again and again, if it's something that you might like or something, just pause it and try it on your own and see how it works. It might be a fast workflow for you. I hope so. I mean, it works for me. I mean, this is perfect right up my alley right now. I mean, like, I'm loving everything. I can do everything right here. I mean, the template's already set up. As soon as I open up Ableton, it already got eight racks of the Reason rack already in there. Only thing I gotta do is open up Logic with audio tracks, and it's gonna, and you gotta set the input and output of your interface on in Logic though. Let me show you that while we're here. So when you go to preferences on your audio and Logic, as you see, I'm using a mixer to run my audio out from the computer into my mixer. And then I'm running it back into my interface, and then my interface is sending it to you guys. I mean, sending it back in digital. So this is how I have it routed. So if you guys do have a mixer, I'm running the digital out into my mixer, and that's gonna give me an analog sound when I'm recording it back into Logic. And then you can add your other effects on there, and your sound's gonna be real, real, real fat. You guys gonna love it. But I mean, this is how I have my interface set up right here. I have my output coming out through my interface, and I'm running an input into the mixer so I can actually record my mixer settings right into Logic. All right, so you guys got that. You guys have, you see at the bottom right here, the audio devices, rewire behavior. Make sure that right there is turned off. Apply changes. You guys are all set. I'm Slump Music. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.